Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Farming Simulator 17. And I'm recording this right after the last one, though in between I started to play with the steering wheel, see if I could get it to work on the game right now. I'm trying to smash everything on this desk forward and see if I can make it happen. Hooked it up and it left kind of a low rumbling noise when I would turn the steering wheel. And this desk that I'm using, this table, it vibrated so much, it was almost like, I don't know, the sound of an oboe. Whoa, I don't know, it was a weird sound. Now that I've taken it off, I see I'm drifting, and I can't figure out why. So, oh, yeah. Anyway, what I think I'm going to do this episode is do something a little bit different. I'm going to drive around, and we're going to look at the whole map. I think that is something that, I don't know, I haven't seen a Let's Play out there that has done that yet. I know Daggerwind's doing a good job of doing, I think he calls it his garage episodes, where he'll take out all the equipment, he'll buy it all, and then get a chance to walk around and look at it. That's my road, right? 9. So, no point in me duplicating something like that. He's done a great job at it already. But other than driving to places incidentally, I've not seen anyone really just make a point of driving the whole map. So I think we'll do that this time. But I want to run back over to the farm and start up the equipment again. This isn't looking right. Oh, there we are. Okay. Because I had turned off the computer several times trying to end the game, trying to get the steering wheel to work. But even this is drifting ever so slowly to the left. I missed something. That was not it. Where am I? Okay, my farm's out over there somewhere, isn't it? We'll try this again. So we're seeing some of the country that I wasn't expecting. That's the back of Farm 11 right there. Okay. Actually, the front of Farm 11, or Field 11. Which means we are up this dirt road over here. There we go. What is happening here? In fact, this is much easier in the cab. There we go. So we've got to get him going again, but I'm sure he's getting low on seed. There's not enough seed in that, that sower to do an entire field. So, and then we've got a cultivator in this field, right? What's going on over here? Yeah, okay. So let's... I guess we'll park this guy over here. Right there. Alright, move over here. Let's get him going again. About there. Okay. And, oh, there's a problem. We saw last episode that these guys take quite a bit of room to turn around. I wonder if this tractor is going to be in the way. I wouldn't have thought so originally. Just put this guy in here for now. Alright, let's see. DPI switch. There we go. We should get in the proper door. Whoa, or jump on the cab. Okay. So let's just park this guy over here. And run up there. And bring this guy down, reload the seat into it. The other one's still running, right? Yeah, he's way down over there. Okay. So in here, turn it on, V lifts it up. Let's get down there and get some seed. It does control better from inside the cab, and it's easier to talk, but it's much easier outside to deal with the equipment that's attached to it, or backing into places like this. And we need to find a home for our loading trailer, too. Or whatever that trailer is officially called. So, this was the idea by putting all this stuff here. We can park this guy kind of in between the seed and the fertilizer, and theoretically, fill up both? Seed maxed out. Why did the seed max out? Let's back up some more. No. Huh, why did that max out? Let's go back a little further then. No. Huh, I don't know why. 89%. And yet, we still have the containers back there, so they've not run out. Okay, well, we'll go with it. Figure that reason out some of the time. So, do we thread the needle? Yeah, let's try it. What could possibly go wrong? That's a catchphrase that Quill18 uses on everything. I need to come up with a catchphrase for my channel. What could it be? Something that is noble or rambler oriented? Don't know. Okay, we're still set for barley. And I'm turning somewhere around here. There it is. Let's just grab the old tire tracks. Pretty much like that. Yeah, this would be easier out here. So, let's cut in a little bit just to make sure that we don't have a gap anywhere. Alright, hire this one out. Looks good. Now, what side is it going to throw me off to? If I'm over here, will it toss me into the seed or toss me into the soil? Into the soil. Maybe that's what it is. It doesn't toss you into an area that's been worked. That could be it. Alright, with that, both these guys are running. There are no more other jobs. Helper E is blocked. Was this Helper E? Where's Helper E over there? Where's the... No, that one's running. And that one's running. Okay. So that must have been the old message. Alright. So, yeah, there's nothing else for us to do here other than fertilize. Fertilize probably the next one. The next project. And the sprayer that I want to get can only be brought with the three-point hitch. So we can't go pick it up with the ball hitch here. So, yeah. Let's just go... Helper J has completed their task. Let's head over here first. Then we'll go and kind of methodically drive around the map and see everything. I'd almost rather drive in a tractor. Let's think about that. Let's park this over here. And is that truly a driveway? It looks like there's a garage under there. Boy, I bet they've got drainage issues. I wouldn't design a garage that way. You can hook this trailer up to this truck here. Alright, so let's put this guy away. Something else we could do too. So we could put him away, but we haven't collected eggs. Let's go take a look in here real quick. And you gotta jump over because there's no interacting with the doors. Now, if we switch over to statistics... Yeah. No. There we are. We'll see that the coop has 5 eggs in it. Somewhere. And there's our drift. I'll have to figure out what's causing that drift. If we walk over, I just picked up 1. 2. 3, a gold nugget. Four, and what'll absolutely drive you nuts is usually there's one less than you find one less than there actually is. So I've in 15 along Westbridge Hills, I used to find them up on the roof of this thing, of the house that the chickens had in that one. Well, I'm gonna consider that good enough. Okay, jump over. That's now in our backpack. So if we manage to get to the part of town that has the map over here that has the chicken egg drop off. Let's see. Where do eggs go? Well, that's where the chickens are. Where's an egg symbol? Okay, I would have assumed it'd be in town. The spinnery is in town, so your wool goes in there. So let's see if we can find eggs here. No eggs. So that's not going to clue us in. Huh. I don't know. Well, we'll discover that someday. Anyway, back out of this. And let's... Question is, cab, will this be easier to drive in? Whoa. No, I think I will just get used to the lizard. Let's put this guy over here. I'm going to put these kind of items in this area. So there's the plow. Eventually we'll have a couple of plows deep and a couple of cultivators deep. Wow. See, I can't tell my depth of field as well when I'm inside the tractor. So right about there. Okay. So what is that? V... and Q. Okay. So this guy will park over here with this one. Alright, let's go grab the pickup. Otherwise, what's our plan here? Actually, let's do this from 9. Alright, now I don't have a pointer. Okay, gotta go this way. And we are here. We have been down this path, out through here, back up this path. That's the majority of what we've done. We've done this loop. We've been up in here. We could take the grand loop, but that'll still miss a lot. Let's go drive here to the pig farm. And then let's head back out. Head up this guy, maybe see this loop up here. What is this? That's interesting. I don't know. Okay, change of plans. Let's go down to field 20 and head up behind it, drive all of this. Come back out, then we'll... Yeah, let's just go driving. Okay, so 9 gets that off our screen, fired up into the cab, and use the pedals. There we go. So if we were going to go to that one area, it'd be down here. I guess let's get the first little 9 going there. So we want to get across there. That's the one thing. If we want field 16, we're going to have a hard time getting to it. Because I can't really cross those rocks right there to get between 19 and 16. So if we get 16, we're going to have to go all the way down to the main road. Yeah, because what I thought was a road between 19 and 16 is actually this railroad track. Now, I have driven on the railroad track in my other game. It can be done. It's a little ridiculous, but it can be done. Clear that way. Let's go for it. 55 out here. 50. And this road is coming up. Is this the right one? No. We need to be on this side of the river. So this dirt road right here. Okay. In fact, I think that's the field right there that I did the intro video in. The little scene at the beginning of this video. I think it was in here with the mountains in the background. Those mountains, yeah. So, from here, let's first head off to the east and see what that grid is. Can we get there from here? Yeah, we can. Then we'll head into the wooded area. All the wooded area, we can plant trees and cut them and... Whoa, that was my turn? No, we're going to go further. Now, you can do what you want in there. It's available for you. What are you? Oh, I think I know where I'm at. Where's my cat? There I am. Winston Tree Nursery. Okay. So this... Let's go in here. Alrighty, so... Not where I wanted to go. How do we get in there? I guess we'll go the other way. So while I'm staring at the road, you guys go ahead and stare off in the, out on the horizons and just look at how beautiful this game is. So much to do. And all these forested areas are available to cut trees down if you choose to, or you can plant them somewhere else if you don't want to ruin the scenery, and then plant them and then cut them down. No natural trees here, a little gazebo camping area. Ah, that's nice. Stop bouncing here. Any chance we have any gold in here? Are you? No, no gold nuggets. And I can't get out of there? I can. Okay. We have a loop here. So maybe this is kind of a campground. Well, there aren't any spots cleared out for that. Mostly just a day picnic area. Maybe we'll say it's that. Let me get back in the cab where I can control this better. There we go. Alright, so let's come out more toward the west end. We'll take off, say, on the north edge of this. Whoa. No guardrails over here. Alright, so I can head down this area. I have a four-wheel drive area. What if the other truck would drive differently? Though there'll be lots of mods for this game soon. There'll be lots of four-wheel drive and probably some Jeeps and other vehicles to drive. Okay, so we're coming out into here. Where to? Let's go across this way. Oh, a little bridge. Oh, little bridge. Wow. That's a nice view. Move out a little bit here. Here in the lily pads. Out onto the main road again. This is the back of 16. Okay, let's head up to the pig pen. Take a look at that. That'll be two lefts from now. If I head out here, you guys can see more of the map, I guess. So I'll just make this work. I may have to talk a little bit louder to get above the engine noise. So that's where we just did that one fertilizing job. This is the... I didn't miss my turn, did I? I missed my... Nine? I missed my turn, yep. Anyway, this is field five up here that we did all of the harvesting, the wheat. All right, there's my turn. This will head up to the pig farm. Got a water tower up over here. Turn over here brings us to the pig farm, so when we get pigs, we'll back the trailer. Helper I has completed their task. Back the trailer into there and unload. This is where you pick up your slurry, your fertilizer that the pigs make. Got some storage over here. This is where you blow the straw in for bedding. The more pigs you have, the more you'll blow in. Also, the more water you'll put in right here, and the more feed you'll dump in right here. Okay, so lost nine there. Let's see. From here, let's go look at the biogas plant just to the west of us, and then we'll cross the river, go north, and take a look at the north end up there. Okay. Yeah, I'll stay in this view. Well, you guys can see more of the map. There's a biogas plant over there. Authorized vehicles only. The railroad down below. American flag up there. So, oh wow, it's the sound of the flag. Yep, I thought of a lot of things in this game. This right here is a scale. Actually works. So our lizard pickup weighs almost 1,000 pounds, so it's a half ton, or a half ton vehicle. Normally that would be closer to 2,000 pounds. It feels a little light. Anyway, here's where you would dump your... Oh, this is what I'm going to have to learn. I would have dumped grass in here, but I've seen so many people dumping grass and saying it doesn't work. So I'm going to have to learn how that process works here. Otherwise you can when you cut up your corn. Let's see. If we go into here, plowing, sowing. Harvesting, root. Anyway, no, I'm not seeing the word I want. Anyway, there's stuff you dump in here. I've lost the terms. But out of this, you will turn it into silage. We'll say a mulch. Think of what you buy in the bag at the store to add to your garden. And there's a whole economy involved in that. You can create quite a bit of income that way, as well as income from the forestry back there, or anywhere that you want to cut down a tree and haul it in and sell it. So these guys are mostly just for show. We've got our hydroelectric dam over here. Let's drive in there and see that. Might even see another zombie or two. Still Halloween for this recording. Hop out and take a look here. Authorized personnel only. That's a dead end. Nice river, though. Yeah. If I keep moving, you won't notice that I'm drifting. stairs. Yeah, we're going to get to go up quite a ways. Ooh, gold nugget. Now, from what I understand, if you find 10 of them, the rest of them will show themselves on the map so that you're not, you know, so frustrated getting to 50 or 60 and then just give up. So, kind of hesitant about the idea of suddenly gaining $1 million. You know, it doesn't seem all that realistic, but things in this game are very, very expensive. So, in reality, I don't think that $1 million would go all that far. And dead end here. Oh, there's another one. Okay. So, it would give us a boost to be able to get enough equipment and animals to be able to see the game better. So, you could think of it that way. If I was playing for myself, I would skip it. I'd want to build it up from scratch. But a lot of what a Let's Play is a demonstration of the game. As well as the fun of playing the game, but you know, you're going to watch a Let's Play and then kind of make your decision if you want to buy the game. So the more features you get to see in the Let's Play, the more satisfied you are that you've seen what the game has to offer. So there is that reasoning there. Why does the 9 keep going away? I don't think I'm doing that. Anyway, let's do the other one. So, oh. See, the map makes it look like there's a way to go all the way north here, but there isn't. Okay. So let's go all the way to the west and then head north and go over the top loop. Then we'll cut down through the middle, maybe, and do the bottom loop. Okay. And I forgot to turn my timer on, so I have no idea how long this episode's going to be. So, train station here. We saw this one when we were on the train. $50 and probably a $35 over here. Yeah. There's that loading area. I don't remember where this is. Alright, we'll head north from here. Narrow bridge over there. Okay. So this car that we're passing, you see it looks like a late 90s to 2000s model. This looks like a 1980s pickup, maybe 70s. I'm thinking, well, 70s to 80s. Just kind of gauging the era of the vehicles here, how current the models are. So there was something back over there. Let's go see what that is. Imagine most of these places are sell points of one kind or another. My map went away again, huh? There we go. Yeah, we're coming up on something. No words there. So if you buy this field, you'll have some vehicle storage right there. So you are the what? Ah. Right. Agribusiness. Okay, well, yeah, that's all it's going to tell us. Well, one of these days we'll have to discover what that is. Meanwhile, let's keep going. Map is gone again. What causes the map to go away? What am I doing? Oh, okay, I did that last time, didn't I? I turned it to the big map and then I turned it off. Okay, that was my fault. Alright, have we been here before? No, there's one of these back behind our place. Ooh, look at the view of this area though. We gotta go look. So the inn is over here. Oh, another gold nugget. Well, I guess we're going to need to be outside to get the view. There we go. Where's the down? There it is. And that's probably a footpath there down to a little gazebo. Okay. We'll head out this side this time. Let's see what that is across the way. Well, this is the top of the hydroelectric plant. Ah, okay. Let's go see this. Do not enter. Authorized personnel only. That kind of reminds me of Half-Life 2. Oh, that was a fun game. Get back into that one of these days. Just because. Whoa. And my cameras are I'm drifting. That's not a good place to be at if you're gonna drift, huh? Yeah, here's the land. So where are we? 9? We are kind of in the northwest corner. So that puts town way off over there. I got enough drift off of here. Okay, let's go back. Secret passage. Yep. You can jump in the water. Well, I wonder if you can get back out if you jump in the water. Let's not try that. Alright, so we'll back up with the other pedal. And where to? We're heading east. So what's the yellow out there? Sunflower? There's something down below there. Oh, this road does a switchback? Oh, this is the road that we didn't get to see. And we'll run down there real fast and come back. So the goal by the time we get finished with this series is to have this map pretty much memorized. Now, could we have gotten through there? Doesn't look like it. It is odd that they don't give you a way to drive through. Huh. Okay. Alright, head up here and continue east, over the top, then down to the southeast corner of the map. So here's the source of the river for the map. The plant then drops down the mountain and down to the valley, and then finds its way off the map at the other end. So we got a farm over here, railroad track over there, biogas plants right over there. This is Sunflower. Right? Well, it reminds me of mustard plant, a distance. What are you? What are you? The leaves kind of look like soybean. I've not seen this model before. I don't know what it is. At least I'm not seeing it in this stage of growth. It's probably not going to give me a hint here, is it? Okay, well, we're in field number 3. So, fertilize this guy for only 3,000. Back up. What is this? This way? Yeah. Field 3. That's canola. Okay, I've not seen canola at this point before. That is second to the last. 3. Oh, that is the end. So it'll dry out and ready to harvest later. Okay. Very interesting. So that's what canola looks like. Continue our path here. So canola looks rather interesting. It'd be nice to have a crop of that on our map. Dive into here. Ah, the fueling station. Okay, we'll play with this. Where's the gas cap? Usually on the driver's side. I think it's it there. Yeah. So this is kind of odd, pulling in this way. Normally these would be reversed the other way so you can drive right through. How do you get to this? Get the sense someone from another country is trying to design an American gas station. Okay, well, anyway, let's hit the refill. Yeah, 3 liters is all it took after all this driving. That doesn't feel that well balanced either. So that's something else that needs to be tweaked on this lizard pickup. Okay, so we'll continue on our way. Actually, what have we got here? Let me look at the map again. Got a loop up there in the corner to go explore. I think that is accessed here. Yeah. All right, let's go do that real quick on our way down. 99. There. Car coming. This way? Yeah, this way. Then we'll probably end this episode in town. See the zombies one more time and kind of look at the storefronts. See what's actually out there. We've got 3 or 4, maybe 5 forested areas on the map. We want to come in here and clear this area out and do some logging. Or you can plant trees in your own fields. If you don't want to ruin the look of the map and log those trees instead. A work shack here. Outhouse back there. Yeah, hiding back there behind. Bet you there's a gold nugget in the outhouse. Oh. See a bunch of mushrooms to the left. Ah, the details are nice in this game. Alright, if I go down below, that will take me out as well. Yeah, campground would have been good. Little spaces off to the sides. Of course, then you wouldn't want to log it, would you? Alright, so let's take this thing south. It's not obvious where the sun is, just kind of a bright area. Oh, at 2 in the afternoon, I guess south would be right there, and that's almost the same as what we're looking at. So I'm heading to here. I need to get back onto the main road. Place is out that way. So we're going to come along the back side where field 16 would be if we did buy it. That's this field right here. So it's a decent sized trip to get there. What is down there? Can I back up? Yeah. I've not been down here before. Narrow bridge. Okay. back side of this. Oh, we just came from here. This is the nursery. Get all the trees. Okay. Now, I don't know if you interact with the nursery and buy any trees there as well. Didn't explore it that closely. So we'll head south to the main road over here. And we'll go do something I've been wanting to do ever since I got this game. What happens when you try to drive into that tunnel? I gotta know. We're clear, we're clear. So, am I gonna hit a dead wall here? I would assume I am. We're gonna get a warning. What's gonna happen? It's the dome. That's what it is. We're actually living in a dome. Well, now you know. Okay, so we've got more to this direction, to the south. And to the south, I believe, is where you buy the animals. So we've got a good-sized field over here. Looks like sunflower seed ready to be harvested there. And all of these crops continue on whether you do the work or not. Here in a few days, that's going to be all harvested, and they're going to be planting something new in there. So the farms do work. Here's manure that's been building up from all of the animals that are over here. Though we can't actually see any animals, huh? Would have been nice. But you would pull into here and interact with, I'm thinking the R. No. So I can't do anything without a stock trader, I'll bet. Though I would think that I could buy them here just to stop engine, exit, cruise, honk. No. You can buy the animals to be delivered as well as pick them up. So I would think that I could interact with this. Interesting. No, we'll have to figure that out someday. Here's the interaction for this field. Here's where you can park your equipment if you buy the field. So you don't have to drive everything over to the field every time you want to harvest. And we'll head down this direction. Got another field over here. I have a feeling this episode's going to go quite long. Again, I don't remember what time I started. Didn't set the timer. It doesn't feel like it's drifting anymore. Looks like it's going pretty straight. So, I've got another narrow bridge going back to the highway over there. Drunk driver here. So, do we want to take the bridge or not? C9. So, otherwise we're driving fields. We have a little something hiding due south of us. Let me get my mouse in the right position there. There. And then we have Maplefield Mill over there to the far west. Haven't seen up in that area. And the sawmill. Okay, so if I cross over, let me do it this way. Let's cross the river right here, head up here, make this loop, come down, and then we'll explore the town. So let's do that. All right, so 9, 9. Okay, steering carefully with the keyboard. Whoa! We gotta do that again. Yeah. But we gotta do that from the cab. Whoa! Okay. Too much fun. I'm heading... Yes, I'm heading that way. Don't see the road from here. There it is. It drops down. So more vehicle storage if you buy this field over here. So a lot of them, most of them have nearby storage. Some of them share. I assume you're going to buy everything in the area, probably. Okay, clear and clear. All right, entering town, 25 miles an hour. Turn at the... Is what I want? I think it's what I want. So you get on our side of the road. So, yeah, I think that's the route I wanted to take. Get up over the top. Whoa. Yeah, that didn't work. Get back in the cab. Reactions are much faster from this view. So we've seen this route many times. This comes back behind us. And first dirt road to the right heads up to field 14. Which is now completely sowed. So next episode we'll get so we don't need to go in here. Actually, we do. Let's go look at the... Oh, we didn't check out the cow farm when we were down there. Let's go take a more thorough look at the sheep farm first. This way, right? Yeah. What was I saying? I don't know. Okay. Yeah, we got distracted again, didn't we? No farming this episode. We'll go this way. So, what do we have here? I don't know what this first bay... Oh, this is the wool. Okay. As soon as you purchase some sheep, they'll start producing wool. Over time, a pallet with several sacks of wool will appear right here. You can pick it up with a front loader and transport it to the spinnery where you can sell it. Alright, so the wool will appear here. Let's see, I want to back up. And you can unload the sheep right here. That puts them inside. Looks like you feed them here and water them there. And then you, when you get done, you stand over here and just look at the view. Wow. That's the best looking sheep farm I have ever seen. Okay, continue our route. You guys can look at the scenery while I'm navigating these roads. There we go. So I don't think that's a loop. I think we've got to go back this... Oh, it is a loop. Okay. See my little map there now. But still, we'll stop here. Alright, so back up this way. Find a bridge, get over to the west, come back down through the sawmill. We'll look that area over. Then we'll get back into town and or get down to the cow farm area. But I've got to decide if I'm going to edit this episode down and try to clip out enough parts to squeeze this into an hour or less, or we'll just have fun with a long episode, a special episode. So... We've been here. We're going across the top. I see, we went north when we got to the end last time. We're going to go south this time. Alright, so clear if I go quickly. 15 on the bridge, 35 otherwise. And that's it. Okay, that's our sawmill. So it looks like you dump off your wood chips over here. Let's go ahead and read the question mark. Here you may unload and sell your wood chips. Oh, glad they enlightened us there. Then your logs. So in reality, they would drop the logs across this track right here. And I believe the finished product will roll out on this guy and be loaded onto semis and rolled away. Alright, so you dump off your logs over here. You can sell logs here. Straight and long pieces without branches earn you more money than short and bent ones. Okay. And also, over here, if you want to sell wood, you can simply drop it in the mill pond. And the same things, the straighter and longer they are, the better. So you can dump your stuff in here and see it floating away. I don't know if there's an animation and maybe it pulls up inside, or eventually you just have this huge pond full of logs eventually. Not sure. Okay, so let's do one of these. Whoa. Okay. I let go of the button and it didn't seem to do any good. Alright, continuing south. So there's the control point for that field. Road is clear. I'm watching my map at the same time. There's something back over in there. I think it's all decorative for the railroad. We've got the lodge over here. Okay. Where to? Let's park in this one. Oh, there's someone walking across the... There's a zombie in there. Oh, that's pretty good. Let's do a screenshot there. There. Okay. We're going to get traffic in our way, or in the way of traffic here. So let's park the rig. Yeah, that's a great parking job. Okay. We want to take up two spaces so no one will park next to us and scratch our jalopy here. Anyway, let's hop out and we'll take a look at the lodge over here. Can't get inside, unfortunately, but it's quite a building. One of the reasons why people come to the Goldcrest Valley. What have we got over here? No, there's no connection. I guess you got to go inside, and if you're a guest, you get to come back outside and go into here. Aha! Go swimming. Again, I guess you would get out if you came out over here. And I cannot go down underwater. Okay, so it holds me at level. Okay. Bar area. Got a lot of decorations. Sports cool bag. Go around this side. Back to our vehicle. Alright, road is, you know, kind of clear. We'll go for it anyway. I have a feeling this episode is now going quite long. So let's get this tour done. Alright, so we're coming into the town. This is the pathway we would take to go over to our... Let's stop here a second and zoom out. If I want to get to cows, it's clear over there, we're here. So if we go south, behind the store, we'll drop into where the... right there. Drop into where the cows are. So we'll go check that out. Then we'll wander through the town a bit. Stop sign, floor it. And all the creepy people are here. I walked through them earlier, and every once in a while they'll say, hi. Okay, so cows are. Let's look at the town while we're going through here. And housing as well as storefronts. We want to go south over there. Wow. So it took a lot of time to create all these models. Look at the yarn right there. That's where you'll sell your yarn. That'll be the spinnery. So head over here. If you buy cattle, it's going to store over there. Map down there kind of indicates there's a turn-in, but I don't see one in front of me. So this is our turn-in. Alright, so it looks like we feed right there. And I'm going to make our slurry over here. Yep, so you fill up your spray tanks there. And make your silage over here. What was that one? Well, that's... Is that bedding? Kind of thinking that would be bedding right there. So you blow the straw into there. That's my guess. This must be... I don't know, I was going to say loading, but... I would think there would be a double fenced area if that was loading for to move your cattle in initially. In and out. But maybe that is the case. That looks like water. Okay. We'll get into all the animals eventually. Okay. We'll pull out of here. Spinnery is there. I see. So we're going north again? No, we're going west. Alright, so... You've got yarn on pallets, you will bring your trailer, or just stick it on a forklift and move it into that yellow square over there. But, not a lot of room to move that big trailer in there, is there? So you'd want to have it at the back end of your trailer to back the trailer in. It's got to enter that space. Otherwise, you've got a forklift off your trailer into there. Actually, we'd probably just put them in the back of the pickup, huh? Yeah, that would work. Alright, so let's drive around town a little bit, then we're going to call this one done. So we've seen the main road out over there. Let's... Another road over there. Let's go around over the bridge. Looks like another gas station. Is this one built properly? See, in a gas station, you got to be able to pull in and pull straight through. These are all going perpendicular. Well, okay. I guess it just makes it more challenging to get... back up. What was that? To get the bigger equipment in and through. Alright, we've got a diner here. Is this a sell point? It is not. It's just decoration. Okay, so let's do a U-turn. That is strange. I wonder if I'm at the 15-minute mark. That seems to be when the lag starts every time. I'd be curious to find out if I back up a little bit if this is around the 50-minute mark. Again, I don't know. I'm doing this blind. But I've got the lag all over my screen again. So maybe that is going to dictate how long my episodes are going to be. You got a bank symbol over there. You got an egg symbol over there. Let's back up. Wait for the zombie to go by. Don't want to make him deader than he is. So you click on that, you can get to your finance screen, which you can also get to from hitting your escape and moving over to here. And reminder, we do have a $75,000 loan we got to pay off soon. I believe there's an interest payment every time you hit midnight. But you can sell your eggs over here. Let's do that. And we'll do the question mark first. Wow, the lag is bad. If you're carrying chicken eggs, you can sell them here by simply walking into the symbol. Alright, let's see what happens. We got 19,856. Just sold $34 in eggs. Okay. So we had five eggs, maybe. Maybe think of that as five dozens, or maybe think of that as five cases. Panoramic Maplefield Real Estate. So all of these buildings have got names on them. That's kind of the fun part of driving around town. They went to a lot of trouble to come up with a whole variety of businesses. Yeah. Well, you're a well-dressed zombie. Gotta say that.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. So, we'll go this route over the bridge. Then we'll take a turn where? These are all houses out here. I want to get into some stores. Oh, there's something right there. What is this? Can't quite see that. Randall something window tinting. Okay, here it is. So Randall window tinting. There's the hours. Let's see, when are they open? Can I get to where I can? I'm gonna have to walk out there. No, can't quite see. But we'll turn, head into the shopping center, and that'll probably be the end of our tour. Stores over there, something's on sale. Something over there, looks like a bunch of newspaper boxes. They sell newspapers. Goldcrest Arcade there. What is this thing? Don't know. Oh, there's something right there. Notice. Monitored by video camera. I wonder what that is. Looks like a hotel to me, or a motel. Yep. Here we go. We've got the Patterson Sandwich Gold Mine, Maplefield Bank, Gold Value Barbecue, Frosty Delights. Another ATM you can check your finance information. The Arbol Garden Center. The Teuton Common Tanning Salon. Frosty's Delights. And Patterson's Sandwich Gold Mine. Alright, well, I think we're going to call this one done. Got another diner across the way. Yeah, I think we're finished this time. So, not much more that we haven't seen. There's a few sell points we didn't get to. Like, I'm looking at the little mini-map right there. 25 over at the bottom. There's something we could sell there. We didn't see that one. But that's, for the most part, Goldcrest Valley. So next time, you know, we'll get back to doing some farming. Oh, I know one thing I want to do. Let's get the speed kicked up. We need to get our stuff. We'll go to 15. And we'll go to 30. We've got to advance some time so we can get into the next stages of growth on our own crops. So we can't run everything one for one. So maybe after we kind of get everything established and figure what we're doing, we'll run it at maybe five speed, five for one. And that way, within a couple of episodes, we'll actually see a sunrise to a sunset. Probably a good plan. Anyway, this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching. Hit the like and subscribe down there if you would. And I will catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.